and he began to show me the seals were open and had been for quite a while. He had me look on the web for many things and show me all the writers had been, what they had already been doing all throughout the earth. For days and night, the green horse was under my couch making his horrible horse noises until I was shown to paint all of four of them. They could be heard for weeks on out writing and writing and writing on my wooden floor. But what they have planned for America is they will be riding, and they will continue to ride throughout the earth until the end of tribulation. You will find this also in your Bible. I did not believe that the last seal was opened, but I'm telling you that it is, and that seal is coming to our own land soon from this vision that I saw of this man getting his head cut off was in America. I've also seen a young preacher in his church. He's laying face down on his carpet in the floor in front of his pulpit before the Lord, and he's weeping. His heart is ripped out. He feels it's too late for his church. His church is empty. Many preachers will not weep before the Lord until these events have begun to happen. People will be in fear and will walk out. Many will begin to curse God and shake their fists at him, thinking he has left them, when in reality, he never was with them. The majority of them, he never knew them. They've only been playing church. Again, I have to ask you, do you know his name? Do you have a relationship with him? Well, the Lord likes to be courted. When you're courting someone, you talk to them, you get to really know them well. This is what he wants from you. He's been waiting to get to know you for a long time. He knew you before you were born, Jeremiah 1:5. You can say, he doesn't love me. I've been so bad, he left me years ago. Why don't you call him up and see? He'll answer you. He's still there waiting at the door for you to knock. Time is so short for us now. You say, oh, that's a fairy tale. Well, Jesus said that people would believe in a lie or a fairy tale rather than believe in the truth. I tell you, very, very soon our money will crash. Do not delay getting your affairs in order. Now, people who tell me, when I get older, I'll give my life to Christ. I want to live a little bit first. Well, people, you haven't lived until you know the person who formed you. I do not mean to just say his name out loud. Do you really know who he is? Do you sing songs to him? Do you talk to him? Do you laugh with him? Do you tell him your secrets? If not, then you don't know him. People will begin to have heart attacks. They will faint when these events begin to start, and they will start soon. Why? Because they're sold out to things of this world and not to God. He tells us to put your trust in him, not of this world, because this world will soon pass away. If you make it and live in America, you will begin to see these things of this world passing one by one before your eyes. And then you will learn what is important to you. The real you will begin to surface as each day goes by. When New York falls, you will wish you knew him. If you're there and you make it out, most will not. New York will become radioactive. This will come upon New York as a suddenly, no warning. Again, if you don't know him, you will not escape. Do not fool yourself. Dave Wilkerson has been telling us for years this is coming. He lives in New York. He loves New York. I've seen this man weep with many tears as he delivers his message to his congregation. Many places will no longer allow him to speak. They do not want to hear what he has to say to America and about it. This is not a happy message. It does not tell them that they will be rich or they will have a big house. He tells them the truth and they do not want to hear it because they have itching ears. As I'm speaking to you, many scriptures have been running in the background for you to read. They were given to me in my quiet time. They are what I am speaking to you about in the Word of God. He has shown me as proof. It will come to pass. I was fabricated. He laid them all out for me to see, and I cried as I saw all the destruction before my eyes of this country. I love that I've lived here all my life. Some have called, emailed me, calling me names, thinking that I hate America for posting the videos that I've already made, telling you that China and Russia will invade us. And I'm telling you this because I love you, warning you, so you'll be ready. You will not be caught unaware. I have looked up the meaning of each important word on the scriptures to make it very clear the meaning of each word, so you will know that it will happen. Still, many will not believe and have trusted the words of false prophets. When this flood hits the East Coast, if you live within 300 miles and you are waiting to get to know him, you will not make it. The invasion of Russia will not be a pretty either. It will be swift and very ugly. It comes first. When the earthquake hits the heartland, if you're still waiting to make a decision of him and it hits you, will not make it out alive. Your family will not live, and you will be held responsible for them on Judgment Day. When the eruption of Yellowstone hits in a blink, do you think you can outrun the lava? No. The ash will be so choking, with every breath you take, your lungs will be cut like glass slivers. You will not make it. You will not. If you're in Las Vegas and you have not made a decision, for whatever reason you've come up with, or maybe you're the one that tells me I'm waiting for my deathbed. You know, we do not get to choose when or how we die. That's God's choice, for He is God. If you're that one, well, your deathbed will be that day the bomb hits. And it'll be too late for you. You will not make it. Or, if you're the one who lives in Chicago when it gets hit, you will not make it either. Do not wait to call him. If you're in California, why wait? There may not be a last minute for you to call out his name. Call upon him today. Now, I do not know the order of all these happenings. I've not been shown. I know I've said that before, but I want it made very clear. I do not know when or how they will happen in what order. Only the fall of our money will come first. I do know that. There are many false prophets that will come and tell you America will be saved. I tell you right now, they are not hearing for the one and only God, Yahweh. They are not. They're talking out of their head. I am a lay minister. I listen to Yahweh every night when I go to bed, to go to sleep. His word says, if I do not share what he has shown me with you when judgment comes, your blood will be on my hands. I cannot make you believe all that I have shared with you. I do not want your blood on my hands. I see many violent storms coming upon our nation. Once New York is hit, there will be lockdowns from state to state, from town to town. I see our water supplies at different times in different areas to be poisoned. food supplies will be cut off many, many times and then completely stop. Dogs will run in packs throughout our country, attacking people, killing them out of starvation. You need to purchase yourself a gas mask. This is a must. Churches will be robbed as people are in attendance. He gave me this in great detail. Main targets on the West Coast are LAX, San Francisco, Las Vegas. People will begin to eat their pets as time goes by for lack of food. And then they will begin to eat each other. People will be frozen in the streets, for they will have no place to go out of the cold. Others will have heat stroke.